Hey, what's up, Maxie?
What's up?
What are the specific challenges of guarding Kawhi, and how do you feel it went in game one?
I mean, I guess we all know he's a very talented player, right, who can make basically every kind of shot. And, you know, he's very calm in what he does, strong body. So even if you, like, bump him and try to take something away, like a layup, he has this ability to take those mid-range jumpers that can be very hurtful. So, you know, you just got to take the challenge and try to, like, do your best job in contesting every shot and you know, like, try to, like, make it work before he even shoots it.
Dwayne?
Max, how do you feel overall today after playing 36 minutes yesterday?
I'm doing fine. We just practiced a little bit of treatment here and there and getting prepared for the next game.
Kevin?
Maxie, what's the mentality going into game two after getting home court advantage in game one, now that you guys have split or gotten the first game in this series, I should say?
I mean, we expect them to come out even more physical, you know, so we got to be prepared for that and fight back, not back down. I think we should be very confident in the way we play and just approach that and go and keep fighting and competing. I think the mindset should be the same, attack on offense and on defense, like, just stay strong, because we know they're going to play physical and they're going to have all those antics and stuff, but we focus on us, play our game, and come out and play with the right way.
Tim McMahon?
Actually, I'm going to be the jerk who asks you about Kawhi's dunk. You know, obviously, if you want to challenge guys, you're risking ending up on a highlight like that. One, you know, what's that like in the moment? And then two, you know, their reaction when guys kind of flexing over you and you know, just talking trash. Did you feel any sort of way about that?
Well, first of all, I had three fouls already, so I couldn't take a early take foul to stop the fast break. But, you know, this is the playoffs, so I'm going to try to contest the shot. I don't care about that, you know. You don't try to give up easy baskets. I think the stare down should have been a technical foul, in my opinion, but that's not my decision. But, you know, I didn't really care. I get up and try to keep playing, and we kept playing. And, you know, stuff like that happens. Obviously, it was an amazing dunk, because I honestly didn't expect him to jump up and dunk, but it's not going to hold me back, because at the end of the day, every possession counts, and I couldn't foul, and, you know, I would do it every time again.
Brad?
Hey, well, I'll be the jerk to ask a follow-up question about it. You talked about the stare down. Do you think that in any way it gave you guys, or you in particular, you know, kind of a little more incentive? Because obviously you guys responded well after that. We've seen many plays in the NBA where that could be a game-turning play in the other direction.
I mean,
how were you guys able to prevent that from happening?
I can't talk for other guys, but, you know, the way we talk before games, just next play, you know, stuff is going to happen. And, you know, I challenged a lot of shots. I blocked a lot of shots in my career. I got dunked on before, so this is not going to affect then, like, the game, which is, it's 2 points. But you got to keep playing your game, you know.
All right, and then Lon Murray, he's from The Athletic for the Clippers.
Hey, Maxie, so you played in every game against the Clippers this season, and then three of those four games, Clippers shot far below their average from three. And obviously, you're out there on the perimeter, even though you're big. Like, what do you feel is something that you do specifically and the team is doing in general when it comes to defending the Clippers' three-pointers?
Well, we know they have great spot-up shooters, so whenever we, like, play and there's kick-out passes, we try to take that away and make them dribble, make them decisions off the dribble and attack the paint, and then try to rotate and just scramble, you know. They obviously have a lot of talent and a lot of good players, but the main thing for us is to not stop on defense and just rotate and keep scrambling, because you can't give them open looks, because obviously they have great shooters on the team.